哈利路亚，奉主耶稣圣名，我们继续下午的学习。
Holy in the name of Jesus Christ, we continue to learn this afternoon.
在这个下午，我们要继续从米迦他的家庭来做我们今天信仰上的一个警告。
So to, this afternoon, we'd like to use the family of Micah for our warning.
在我们谈米迦的家庭以前。
Before we talk about Micah's family,
在这边要先做一个校正，做一个 correction.
I'd like to make a correction.
这个士师时代，总共是450年。
The time of Judges was 450 years.
我们今天早上说350，一不小心就吃掉100年了。
And so this morning we said it was 350, so we're lacking 100 years.
但是其实士师时代它的年代不是那么好断定啊。
But the time of Judges is actually hard to determine.
我翻了一些不同的参考资料。
And I've gone through numerous resources.
它如果只从书卷，士师记的书卷本身啊。
If we look at the book of Judges itself.
就是从一个一个士师的时间把它加起来，把它加起来啊。
If we add the time of each judge together.
士师记大概是这一段的记载是350。
Then the time is actually spans over 350 years.
但是它还有一些空白。
But there are some blanks.
就是从约书亚之后呢。
And that is after Joshua.
一直到撒母耳的时间呢。
Until the time of Samuel.
所以啊，你如果把它全部整体加起来看啊。
So if you add all of this together.
按照使徒行传里面告诉我们这是450年。不过他说。大约450年了。
According to the book of Acts, it tells us around 450 years.
所以既然圣经是这样写，
If this is what the Bible says,
那就是标准答案，大约450年。
Then it is the correct answer, around 450 years.
但是其实啊，不管它多少年啊
，No matter how many years,
它都是一个以色列人信仰失败的一个记载啊。
It is the time and the failure of the faith of the Israelites.
如果这样子回头再看一下啊
，If you look back,
或许吃掉一百年反而是件好事啊。
Maybe if they were lacking 100 years, this is a good thing.
这种悲惨的时间、黑暗的时期，难道不是越短越好吗
？Isn't it better to have a shorter time of a dark age and a tragic age?
我们今天也是啊，在信仰的路上，人生的脚步啊。
Today in our journey of faith and our steps.
真的啊，一个人这个信仰的黑暗时期也要越短越好。
We want the period of time where our faith is dark to be
short. 不要总是在罪恶痛苦当中一直做循环。
We don't want to have a continuous cycle in sin.
追求世界，遇到困难，走投无路，祷告求神，得到帮助，又回到世界，这不是很可怜吗？
That we pursue the world and we come to a dead end, then we cry out to the Lord, pray, and we come back. Isn't this tragic?
所以在彼得前书里面，彼得告诉我们了。
That is why in 1 Peter, he tells us.
彼得说啊，这种追求世界的日子够了，够了啊。
He said, it is enough that you pursue the days of the earth.
那我们就要问问自己一个问题啊。
So we have to ask ourselves.
请问一下，对我们够了吗
？For us, is it enough？
所以啊，要所以啊，要追求世界日子要够了，这个士师记的循环要把它斩断。
And so we should stop the cycle of pursuing the world.
好，那我们再看回来士师记的第十七章。
Let's turn back to Judges chapter 17.
士师记的十七章。
Judges 17.
第二节。
Verse 2.
第二节。他对母亲说：“你那1100舍客勒银子被人拿去，你因此咒诅，并且告诉了我。看啊，这银子在我这里，是我拿去了。”他母亲说：“我儿啊，愿神赐福给你。”第三节。
Verse three.
米迦就把这1100舍客勒银子还他母亲。他母亲说：“我分出这银子来为你献给神，好雕刻一个像，储成一个像。现在我还是交给你。”第四节。米迦将银子还他母亲，他母亲将200舍客勒银子交给银匠，雕刻一个像，储成一个像，安置在米迦的屋内。我们今天早上谈到米迦母亲的问题。
This morning we discussed the problem of Micah's mother.
其实我们今天在讲这个米迦的家庭啊。
We're talking about the house of Micah.
并不是只有针对米迦这个家里有问题啊。
It's not that the house of Micah itself has the problem.
其实米迦的家庭就是当时候以色列大社会的一个缩影。
But the house of Micah was actually a small picture of the Israelites in general.
你从米迦的家庭，你就会看到以色列人的观念。
From the house of Micah, we can see the concept and understanding of the Israelites.
你就能够明白为什么他们有神还是活在黑暗跟痛苦当中。
And we can come to realize why that they are still living in the dark ages, even though there is a God.
所以我们今天早上米迦的，我们讲到说米迦的母亲对信仰的态度。
This morning we discuss Micah's mother's attitude towards faith.
她要祝福就祝福，要咒诅就咒诅。
If she wants to bless, she will bless. If she wants to curse, she will curse.
她没有把这件事情当成一个谨慎小心，而且非常严肃的事情。
She was not very careful and alert in this matter.
她没有是非对错的观念。
And she did not have this concept of what was right and wrong.
如果是外人，我就咒诅她。
If she was a Gentile, she may be cursed.
如果不是那个。那个如果是别人拿我的钱哦
，If someone else took my money, then I would curse them.
我就要咒诅他。
Then I will curse them.
那如果啊是我自己的儿子啊啊没有关系啦，神祝福你啊。
But if it's my own son, that's okay. May the Lord bless you.
那我们今天呢、啊、都非常疼爱我们的孩子。
Today we love our children.
啊，真的啊，有孩子的人呐、啊，就会有很深的体会啊。
Those with children, they will feel this very deeply.
啊，就好是好抱在怀里，哇，放在心上。
When you embrace your child, you put your child in your heart.
宝贝的不得了啊。
They are very precious.
啊，现在我的孩子一个八岁，一个六岁哦。
I have two children. One is 8, the other 6.
我还是啊，晚上三不五时啊，起来开开门。看看他们，看看他们啊，偷看一下啊。
And even at night, I will sneak into their rooms and look at them.
啊，看看他们睡觉的时候啊，这么可爱。
And see how adorable they are while they sleep.
啊，真的啦，睡着的时候都跟天使一样啊。
While they're sleeping, they're like angels.
啊，有时候啊，醒过来啊，又变成小恶魔啊。
But when they wake up, they're like little demons.
啊，真的啊，有时候你看孩子是你心中真的是那种爱到心里啊。
And it is true that you love your child from your heart.
我相信米迦的母亲也非常的爱他。
And I believe Micah's mother also loved him.
啊，但是米迦的母亲爱是没有原则的。
But she had no principle in her love.
哦，一个没有原则的爱。
Someone who loves without principle.
成为对儿女的一种伤害。
It becomes a harm to their children.
哦，所以啊，他母亲说：“哎呀，没有关系呀，米迦，是你拿的，哎呀，神祝福你就好啦。”
So the mother of Micah said, "It is okay if you took it. Then may God bless you."
1100 shekel 到底有多少？
And how much is the amount of shekels they have? 1100.
啊，这个数字啊，我们现在不是很好评断哦。
And it's hard for us to determine this nowadays.
我大概看了一些不同的参考资料，他们有做一个可能性的对比啊。
And they have made some comparisons and numerous resources.
他说1100 shekel 大概是要上班哦，普通人要工作20年左右的薪水啊。
They said 1100 shekels is equivalent to 20 years of wages.
啊，所以你大概如果你一年赚50,000，大概就是100万美金啊。
So if you make 50,000 a year.
好，那20年就是100万啊。
Then, and 20 years would be 1,000,000.
啊，你如果再多赚一点，你一年赚100,000，那就是200万美金啊。
And so, if you make more, if you make 100,000 a year, that would equate to 2,000,000.
啊，不管是100万还是200万，都是一个非常非常庞大的数字啊。
Whether it be 1,000,000 or 2,000,000, it is a great sum.
哦，所以啊，米迦的母亲掉了这么一大笔的钱。
And so Micah's mother had lost such a great sum of money.
哦，非常紧张，非常生气。
And she was very angry.
啊，米迦拿走了这么大笔的一条钱。
And when Micah took this great sum of money,
甚至没有跟他妈妈说一声啊。
He did not tell his mother.
啊，所以啊，当米迦的母亲发现了以后哦。
So when the mother realized this,
哦，她原本从非常愤怒，马上转变，好像通通没有关系。
She turned from being angry to as if nothing had happened.
这个是今天在教育上面的一个很大的问题。
This is a problem in the education.
啊，因为是我的孩子，所以做什么都没有关系。
Because it's my child, no matter what they do, it's okay.
因为我爱他，所以我要让他任意而行。
And because I love them, I will let them do as they please.
啊，却不知道说我们今天所做的选择跟我们对待儿女的方式会主导他们的一生。
But our choices and how we treat our children may actually obstruct their life.
我们看圣经里面讲到以利啊，这个祭司以利啊。
The Bible talks about the priest Eli.
啊，以利啊，侍奉神一辈子。
He served the Lord his whole life.
啊，常常在圣殿当中。
And he was often in the temple.
几十年来站在他的岗位上。
And he kept his position for decades.
你如果看这样的话，他真的是一个好工人啊。
And so from this aspect, he's a good worker.
但是以利侍奉多年的结论是什么？结果是什么？
But what was the conclusion and end result of his service?
结果是神大大的降灾在他家里啊。
God sent disaster on his family.
啊，神跟他说啊，说你们家在你的家中不会有老人啊。
God said that in your household there will not be an old person.
为什么没有老人？
Why is it so?
因为人到中年全部离世啊。
Because they would depart from this world once they reach middle age.
你们会失去祭司的职分。
You will lose your title as priest.
甚至要去跟人家乞讨，要个饼来吃。
And you must beg for food to eat.
这是一件非常可怕的事情啊。
This is something that's very dreadful and frightful.
以利数十年来侍奉神，在神的殿中当祭司。
Eli was a priest in the house of God.
结论却是家里遭受大大的咒诅啊。
But in the end, his family was cursed.
为什么会这样子？
Why was this so?
神说，因为你尊重你的儿子，过于尊重我。
God said, because you honor your sons before me.
所以啊，我们今天要谨慎啊。
So today we must be very careful.
我们是要爱孩子。
We must love our children.
但是我们不能够爱孩子过于尊重神。
But we cannot love our children more than God.
我们不但要爱孩子。
Not only should we love our children.
你如果真的爱他，你一定会教他。
But if you love them, you will teach them.
因为主所爱的，他会管教。
Because God will discipline those he loves.
那你所爱的，难道你不管教吗？
And so if you love them, do you not discipline them?
所以我们在这里看到米迦母亲的问题哦。
So here we see the problem of Micah's mom.
有时候啊，我们今天的父母啊，因为孩子少啊，所以宝贝的不得了。
As parents today, because we do not have a lot of children, we think that they are very precious.
所以啊，有时候我们照顾过头了。
So sometimes we take care of them too much.
我还记得啊，好多年前啊，我在做宗教教育的老师啊。
A couple years ago, when I was still a religious education teacher.
有一次啊，我们跟一个妈妈说她的小孩有问题。
Once we were talking to a mother that their child had a problem.
我们跟她说，她说你的孩子最近的行为怪怪，讲话也怪怪哦。
We told the mother that your child has been acting up in the speech and actions recently.
因为他的孩子那时候一个女儿啊，那时候高中啊。
Because her daughter at that time was in high school.
那我们就跟他讲说，你女儿最近怪怪啊，最近怪怪哦。
So we told her that your daughter is acting strangely.
而且有其他的学生听到你女儿骂脏话哦。
And other students have heard your daughter say cuss words.
所以我们就去跟妈妈讲啊。
So we told the mother.
妈妈非常非常生气啊。
The mother is very angry.
不是对她女儿生气，是对我们生气啊。
Not towards the daughter, but towards us.
说啊，那是你们宗教教育老师有问题啊。
It says that that is the fault of the religious education teachers.
然后啊，她还跟我们说啊，你们懂什么？你们又没有小孩。
She said, "What do you know? You don't have any children."
哇，非常生气啊。
She was very angry.
然后后面又加一句啊，说啊，我的小孩我自己会管，不用你多事。
And said, I will take care of my own children. You don't need to worry about it.
因为什么？因为那个妈妈听不得别人说她小孩有问题。
Because the mother could not accept other people saying that there's a problem with her child.
所以啊，她还跟我们说啊，说你们以后有小孩，自己管好你的就好了。
Said, and she
你就知道了。
In the future, when you have children, you will know and just take care of your own children.
所以因为我们比她妈妈的年纪小啊。
Because we are younger in age than the mother.
所以她妈妈一面骂，我们就一面是啊。
So when she was angry at us, we just nodded and said yes.
后来她的小孩变坏了。
Later on, the child became bad.
交了坏朋友，离开了教会。
And had bad friends and departed from church.
也离开他的家庭，离开父母，就在外面啊。
And departed from the parents and the family.
很多年以后啊，我有一次又遇到了这个妈妈。
Many years later, I encountered this mother again.
这个妈妈主动来跟我说话，而且谈到她的孩子啊。
This mother, she came to talk to me by herself, and she mentioned her daughter.
她只跟我说后悔，真是非常的后悔。
And that she says that she regrets it.
因为她说啊，因为她爱孩子，所以她忍受不了任何人讲她孩子的坏话。
She said because she loved her children, she could not bear anyone speaking badly about her.
她也从来不骂她的孩子，因为她觉得她的孩子好棒。
And she would never chastise or discipline her children because she thought that her daughter was great.
但是到等到整个等到最后孩子走差的路已经来不及了。
But in the end, when the child had deviated, it was too late.
那个妈妈只说啊，她对不起神呐，只能祷告求神带她孩子回来啊。
And the mother said that she felt sorry, towards God, and she had to pray to God to bring
her back. 所以我们再说一次啊。
So let us say this again.
当爱没有规范，只是一种伤害。
When love has no boundaries, this becomes harmful.
啊，这个是米迦母亲的问题啊。
This is the problem of Micah's mom.
啊，我们继续看啊，往下看啊。
If we continue to read,
啊，他的母亲就说啊，啊，愿神赐福给你。
The mother says, "May you be blessed by the Lord."
第三节啊
，Verse three.
第三节，他母亲说：“我要分这银子来为你献给神，来除造一个像。”哦，在这里，米迦的母亲想到一件事啊。
Micah's mother thought of one thing here.
她说：“哇，这个钱拿回来了。
”I have got my money back.
哇，这个1100舍客勒的银子，哇，这么多的钱我都找回来了。
I found my 1100 shekels of silver.
但是在这里啊，米迦的母亲做了一个决定。
So she made a decision here.
她说：“我要把这个银子为你来献给神。”
I will dedicate this silver for my son.
我们刚刚讲说1100舍客勒是非常非常非常多的钱啊。
We just mentioned that 1100 shekels is a lot of money.
但是在这里啊，米迦的母亲啊，却说她要把这一笔钱全部献给神。
But here, the mother said that she would dedicate all this money to God.
来为米迦储一个像啊，一个神像啊。
To make a carved image for him.
在这里啊，我们要想说为什么。
Here we must think why.
他妈妈为什么要拿出这么大的一笔钱来做一个神像？
Why did she take all this money to make a carved image?
这跟前面的咒诅有很大的关系啊。
This has a relationship with the curse from before.
在不知道的状况之下，他妈妈咒诅了拿这个钱的人。
Without knowing it, the mother had cursed whoever took the money.
所以她现在发现了，原来是我的儿子。
Now she realized it was her own son.
糟糕啊，咒诅的话已经发出去了。
She realized she had already spoken this curse.
虽然她后来赶快讲啊，神赐福你啊，神赐福你啊。
Even though she quickly said, "May the Lord bless you."
可是啊，这个妈妈啊，心中应该是有点担忧，非常紧张啊。
But she is probably nervous and worried in her heart.
这里没有讲说她怎么咒诅啊，可能那个咒诅非常严厉，非常可怕啊。
Here it does not record how she cursed, but maybe it was very severe.
所以啊，米迦的母亲啊，心中可能非常害怕，要是这个咒诅应验了怎么办？
So she was very afraid, what if this curse came true?
所以在这里，米迦的母亲要拿钱出来做一个神像。
So she took out her money to make a carved
image. 我们如果把这件事情，两件事情把它连在一起啊。
If we connect these two events.
我们会发现说，米迦母亲处理事情的方式跟观念。
We can see how she dealt with the matter and her concept.
做错事情怎么办？
When she did something wrong, what was she to do?
怕神愤怒怎么办？
If she was afraid of God's anger, what was she to do?
拿钱出来解决，神应该就会原谅吧。
She thought that she took out her money, then God would forgive them.
是不是？哎呀，我讲错话了，我不好意思，我拿钱可以吧？
I've said something wrong, I'm embarrassed, I can take out my money.
所以啊，你看啊，神啊，我已经花了这么多的钱，给你除了一个像，你该原谅我吧。
Look, God, I have taken all this money to make a carved image. You will forgive me.
有时候啊，我们今天信仰路上会陷到一样的观念，错误的观念里面。
Sometimes in a journey of faith, we might still have this wrong concept.
我们以为啊，做错事情只要付出这种金钱上的代价，我们就可以脱身脱罪啊。
We think that we can get out of our wrongdoing and our sins by monetary payment.
我只要付钱。
If I pay,
付完钱我的罪就赦免了。
Then my sins will be forgiven.
做错事情讲错话得罪神没关系啊，我奉献啊。
It's okay if I said something wrong, if I sin against God, I just need to pay an offer.
有一次啊，有一个信徒哦。
Once there was a member.
这个信徒啊，原本是从一个很贫穷，就是生活很贫穷的环境出来的。
This member grew up in a very poor environment.
因为生活很贫穷，所以工作他的生活非常辛苦啊。
And because he grew up in a poor environment, he had a very hard life.
就一直啊祷告求神啊，让他生活能够稳定。
And he prayed for stability.
真的啊，神啊，听他的祷告啊，真的帮助他啊。
God listened to his prayers and helped him.
给他一个好机会啊，来慢慢的生活就好起来了。
And gave him a good opportunity, so his life became better.
有稳定的工作。
He had a stable job.
有舒适的生活。
He had a nice life.
甚至到最后自己开公司做了老板。
And he even opened his own business and became the boss.
从原本三餐不济，到后来生活富裕。
And so before he didn't know where his three meals were from that to luxury and a rich life.
是的，生活越来越好。
Yes, his life improved.
结果就是聚会越来越少。
But he came to service less and less.
以前是天天晚上都到教会啊。
Before he would come to service every night.
每天啊，花很多时间祷告求神帮助。
And he would spend a lot of time in prayer asking God for help.
啊，但是啊，随着工作越来越繁忙，事业越来越大，事业越做越大啊。
As his business became to grow and his career grew.
本来每天晚上聚会，到最后变成只有安息日来。
When he used to come to service every night, he only came now during Sabbath.
越来越忙，从每个安息日来到最后只有灵恩会才出现。
And as he became more busy, he would only show up during spiritual convocation.
甚至到最后有时候连灵恩会都不来啦。
And in the end, sometimes he wouldn't even come during spiritual convocation.
所以啊，教会就去访问他，鼓励他。
So the church went to visit and encourage him.
要提醒他说啊，耶稣在你身上恩典很多，你应该要更热心来回报神啊。
To remind him that he had many blessings in his life from God and that he should repay him even more.
但是啊，教会常常去看他，他却很少来教会。
But even though the church would visit him, he still did not come to service.
到有一次啊，教会去访问他的时候啊。
One time when the church went to visit.
他就转身。拿出他的支票簿来
He turned around and got his checkbook.
然后跟教会的工人说你要多少你说吧
And he told the worker in church how much do you want? Just tell me.
当然不是给工人啊是说我要奉献给教会啦
Of course he was not giving it to the worker but he wanted to offer it for church.
他说要不然你说要奉献多少嘛给钱没问题啦时间我没有啊
And he said it's okay just tell me how much you want me to offer. It's easy for me to give money but time I cannot.
因为有时候我们会用这种金钱上的补偿来弥补良心上的亏欠
And sometimes we'll use money to mend where we lack in our hearts.
有时候我们对自己的儿女也是这样。
And this is how we are also towards our children.
有时候我们对我们的配偶也是这样。
And towards a spouse.
甚至对我们的信仰也是这样。
And also towards our faith.
哇，到最后跟主耶稣讲说，要不然你要多少嘛？你说嘛。
And we might say to God, how much do you want? Just tell me.
神有差你的这些钱吗？
Do you think God lacks your money?
哈该书里面讲说，金子是我的，银子也是我的啊。
The book of Haggai says, silver and gold are mine.
你所有的哪一样不是神给你的？
Everything that you have is not from God.
如果都是神给你的，那你那么骄傲做什么？
If it is from God, why are you so proud?
如果都是神给你的，你还要拿什么来给神？
If this is all from God, what do you have to give to God?
收买神说，要不然你说多少嘛，我付钱可以吧？
And you might say to God, tell me how much and I will just pay the price.
很抱歉啊，财富永远不能够弥补你在神面前的亏欠。
I'm sorry, but riches and wealth cannot repay how much you owe God.
你的这样子的奉献在神来讲没有任何的意义。
This kind of offering to God has no meaning.
神要的是什么？
What does the God want?
神说忧伤痛悔的心我必不轻看啊。
And he says a contrite heart he will not look lightly upon.
所以我们今天不用再自我欺骗了。
So we should not cheat ourselves.
我们不要用啊，哎呦，我有奉献啊，来弥补自己良心上的不安。
We cannot use our offering to calm our conscience.
在这里啊，米迦的母亲啊，说我要拿一大笔钱出来啊。
Here, Micah's mom said that she will take out a great sum of money.
她到底在做什么？
But what is she doing?
在买心灵上的平安啊。
She is buying the peace in her heart.
所以我们来看一下撒母耳记上的第十五章。
If you turn to 1 Samuel chapter 15.
撒母耳记上第十五章。
1 Samuel chapter 15.
撒母耳记上十五章的二十二节。
Verse 22.
二十二节
，Verse 22，
撒母耳说：“神喜悦燔祭和平安祭，岂如喜悦人听他的话呢？听命胜于献祭，顺从胜于公羊的脂油。”第二十三节
，23，
悖逆的罪与行邪术的罪相等，顽梗的罪与拜虚神和偶像的罪相等。你既厌弃神的命令。神也必厌弃你做王啊！这里啊讲的真的非常的严重哦。
Here it's very severe.
我们常常讲到，哎呀，这个拜偶像啦、行邪术啦，这个真是太糟糕了。
Of course, when we say worshiping idols and witchcraft, this is too bad.
我们绝对不会去拜偶像。
We will definitely not worship idols.
我怎么可能去行邪术呢
？And how will I perform witchcraft?
但是在这里啊，却圣经却告诉我们哦。
But here the Bible records.
他说啊。悖逆、顽梗、悖逆的罪跟行邪术是一样的啊。
That rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft.
你这个顽梗的罪跟拜偶像是相等的啊。
And so rebellion is equal to the sin of
witchcraft. 所以啊，在这里啊，当 当以扫啊，当以当扫罗想要用这种献祭啦、牛羊啦各种的方式来买神的喜悦啊。
And so when Saul wanted to purchase the delight of the Lord through his offerings and sacrifices,
神跟他讲说把亚玛利人这些牲畜全部杀掉。
God had commanded him to kill all the livestock of the Amalekites.
他不愿意啊。
But he was unwilling.
而且啊，当撒母耳责备他的时候，
And when Samuel rebuked him,
他说我这是给神的。
He said this is for God.
我是要奉献的。
I want to offer this.
我全部拿出来要捐给神啊。
I'm taking all this out to offer to God.
啊，结果神非常生气啊，结果在这里啊，撒母耳就责备他。
And here Samuel rebuked him.
他说啊，你如果不听神的命令。
That if you do not listen to the commandment of God,
奉献再多都是枉然啊。
Then it is useless no matter how much you sacrifice.
你如果生活当中没有行出神的旨意。
If you do not live out the will of God in your life,
圣工参与再多都是没有用的。
However much a holy work you participate in, it is useless.
我们不要用奉献来弥补良心的亏欠。
We should not use our offering to mend where we lack in our hearts.
更不要以为我多做圣工，我就平安无事啦。
And do not think that the more holy work we do, that we will just have peace.
生命没有改变，信仰没有改变。
Our life has not changed. Our faith has not changed.
没有改变我们的行为，遵照神所要求的去活。
If we do not change our behavior and do according to the will of God.
但是啊，来到教会忙进忙出，我做很多圣工哦。
But when we come to church, we do a lot of holy work.
我们可能就跟啊米迦的母亲没有什么两样啊。
That we might be no different from Micah's mother.
我付出这一些物质来填补我心灵上的亏欠。
I've taken out all these material things to mend what I'm lacking.
我做了很多圣工来弥补我在世界上行为表现的问题呀。
And I do a lot of holy work to cover or mend my actions in society.
我有做很多圣工，神会原谅我。
I've done a lot of holy work, so God will forgive me.
我奉献很多啊，所以我不需要改变。
I've made a lot of offerings, so I do not need to change.
很抱歉，这些都是没有用的。
I'm sorry, all this is useless.
因为神向你要的第一个是什么？
Because what does God want from us?
这里说，听命胜于献祭，顺从胜于公羊的脂油啊。
Here it says to obey is better than sacrifice and to heed than the fat of rams.
而且啊，米迦的母亲还做了一件很奇怪的，也不是很奇怪，米迦母亲也做了另外一件事啊。
Micah's mother also did another thing.
我们看回来啊，士师记十七章啊。
If we turn back to Judges 17.
第三节啊。
Verse 3.
第三节，他母亲说：“我分出这银子来为你献给神。”第四节
，Verse 4，
米迦将银子给他母亲，他母亲将200舍客勒交给银匠。我们读到这里啊，可能觉得，没有觉得有什么奇怪的哦。
We might think that this is not strange.
这里有一个很大很大很大的问题呀。
But there's a great problem here.
原本米迦的母亲所说的哦。
Originally, what the mother said.
她说：“我将这银子。”为你献给神哦。
He said that, she said that I have dedicated the silver for my son.
在原来的文字里面，它是全部哦，哦，它有一个全部这一笔钱，这一笔钱都是要奉献的。
In the original text, he says that she had wholly dedicated the silver.
是整笔哦，1100哦。
That means the whole sum, which is 1100 shekels.
但是你看到后面的时候啊，她到底捐了多少啊
？But how much does she actually give?
200。
200.
200也是不少啊 ,200 不少哦 ,200 不少的。
200 is not a small sum.
200也是、不知道怎么换算啊 ,200 也是一笔非常大的钱啊。
It's actually still a great sum of money.
但是他原本答应的是多少
?But what does she say in the beginning?
他原本答应的是1100舍客勒。
Originally, she had agreed to 1100 shekels.
所以啊你看啊在这里又凸显了以色列人在神面前的一种态度啊。
So here again highlights the attitude they had before God.
有时候嘴巴讲得很大声，行为根本都跟不上。
A lot of times they will speak with a mouth, but their actions will not match.
在神面前答应说，我这边全部都要捐给神。
Before God, she has said, "I will wholly dedicate all the silver."
等到真正该捐的时候啊，又舍不得啊，哎呀，没有啦，两 百就不错了啦。
At the time of offering, she only gave 200.
我听过一个故事啊。
I heard a story before.
他说有一天呢，有一个富翁啊，出去玩啊。
One day, a rich man went to have fun.
啊，这个富翁啊，这个坐在那个出去游湖啊，在那个船啊，在那个在湖上啊，哇，划着小船，非常悠哉，非常快乐，享受他的下午时光。
And he was enjoying his afternoon time on the river on a boat.
啊，但是啊，因为啊，富翁嘛，少运动哦。
And because he's a rich man, he did not exercise a lot.
啊，所以啊，也不太会划船。
So he did not know how to row his boat.
啊，结果啊，玩一玩啊，不小心啊，啊哇呀，就翻到水里去了。
And while he was playing, he flipped over.
啊，结果啊，翻到水里面啊，又不会游泳，非常紧张啊。
And when he flipped over, he could not swim, so he was very worried.
就啊，在这大喊啊，在水底下扑，在水上面扑腾啊，说救我啊，救我啊。
And so he started to panic and said, "Help me, help me."
啊，这时候刚好有个渔夫。经过了
啊。At this time, a fisherman passed by.
哇，他就看到那个渔夫啊，就说：“你救我啊，你救我啊！”
And he called out to the fisherman and said, "Help me!"
啊，跟那个渔夫讲说：“哇，你来救我，我所有的财产都给你啊！”
And he told the fisherman, "If you save me, I will give you all my possessions."
哇，结果那个渔夫啊，哇，赶快划着他的小船要过来救人呐、啊。
So the fisherman rowed his small boat over to save him.
哇，那个财主已经快要沉下去了。
And the rich man was about to drown.
你快点啊，你快点来啊！
He said, "Hurry up!"
你呀、啊，救了我啊！我把我的财产一半都给你呀、啊。
If you save me, then I'll give you half of my possessions.
哇，结果啊，那个渔夫啊，终于划到旁边了，哇，把他拉起来。
So the fisherman rowed right next to him, and then he held him.
全身湿哒哒的，哇，抓着那个渔夫啊，一直发抖啊。
And he was wet from head to toe, and he grabbed onto the fisherman.
啊，说我实在是太感谢你啦，我的财产四分之一一定要分给你呀、啊。
And he said, "I am so grateful for you. I will give you a fourth of my possessions."
啊，等到啊那个渔夫啊把他载到岸边，他安全上路了以后哦。
And when the fisherman took him to the shore and he was safely on shore,
从他湿哒哒的钱包里面掏了两张湿哒哒的200块，说：“哎，给你了。”
He took out two red bills of $100 each. So with $200, he paid him.
人就走掉了。
And he walked away.
这就是人性。
And this is human nature.
有需要的时候都喊得特别大声。
When you have a need, you will call out greatly.
啊，但是啊，随着时间跟环境的变化啊，那个心智一直在改变啊。
But your heart changes, along with the environment
that you're in. 有多少次我们在神面前也是这样。
Many times we are like this before God.
你需要神的时候啊，喊得很大声啊。
We call out to God very loudly when we need Him.
哇，在神面前啊，什么都敢答应，什么都敢应许啊。
And we will agree to many things before God when we need Him.
为什么？因为反正你也没有什么可以再损失啊。
Because we cannot lose anything else.
所以你什么都敢说啊。
So we can say anything.
神啊，只要你帮助我，我的公司经过这个难关。
God, if you help me, my business overcome this difficult time.
我一定做什么，我一定怎么样，都讲了很多啊。
I will do this and that. You'll say many things.
啊，随着环境的改变，随着困难的解决。
But as your environment changes and as your difficulty no longer becomes hard,
就开始有选择性的失忆啦啊。
Then you have selective memory.
有吗？有这种事？我有讲过这种话吗
？Did I say this?
我可能讲错了吧。
Maybe I said something wrong.
可能那个时候我没有想得很清楚啊。
Maybe I did not think very clearly.
哎呀，可能是你们听错，你们误会啦。
Or maybe you have misunderstood me or heard something else.
其实啊，你再解释都没有用啊。
Even though you might try to explain.
不管你怎么解释都是没有意义的。
It is all meaningless.
因为什么？因为你不是在跟人解释啊。
Because you are not trying to explain it to men.
你当初怎么说？你在神面前怎么应许？
How you, what you said initially and what you vowed before God.
这个合约不是你跟我做的哦，不是哦。
And this contract is not between you and me.
所以你不用来跟我讲啊。
So you don't need to come and tell me.
啊，没有啦，我可能讲错了。哎呀，可能你们误会了。
You don't need to tell me that maybe you have misunderstood me or heard incorrectly.
I don't care, 跟我没有关系啊。
I don't care, this has nothing to do with me.
你不用告诉我的。
You don't need to tell
me. 你也不用来到这里寻求一点安慰啊。
You don't need to come to me seeking comfort.Comfort.
哇，传道说，哎，有啦，传道说我可能讲错了，没有任何意义啊。
You don't need to come to me and say, Pastor, maybe I said something wrong.
你当初说了什么，你自己最清楚。
You are very clear on what you said initially.
你也很清楚神听见了你所说的话。
And you are very clear on what God has heard.
啊，所以你今天呢、啊，要改，要变，要反悔。
And so today, if you want to change, if you want to return,
请不要来告诉我。
Do not tell me.
I don't care.
I don't care.
你自己去跟主耶稣讲啊。
Go tell Jesus.
这是你跟神之间的关系啊，跟我来讲干什么
？Because this is between you and him.
啊，我们来看一下传道书哦。
Let us turn to Ecclesiastes.
我们看传道书的也是第五章哦。
Chapter 5.
传道书第五章的第六节，第四节哦。
Chapter 5, verse 4.
他说你向神许愿偿还不可延迟因为他不喜悦愚昧人所以你许的愿应当偿还第五节你许愿不还不如不许第六不可任你的口使肉体犯罪也不可在祭司面前说是许错了错许了为何使神因为你的声音发怒败坏你手所做的呢？啊，在这里啊，圣经特别警告我们啊。
Here the Bible warns us.
没有人要求你要许愿。
No one told you to make a vow.
是在这里啊，他说哇，你可以不要许愿的。
You do not need to make a vow.
你不许愿，你跪下来祷告，神一样会看，会听见，会帮助。
God will still listen to your prayer even if you don't make a vow.
所以，如果你没有打算要还愿。
So if you do not have plans to repay,
哦，所以如果你没有想清楚，
if you do not think clearly,
不要随便乱讲啊。
Do not say it.
哦，他说许愿不还不如不许。
It is better to not to vow than to vow.
than
to vow and not pay.
哦，所以啊，神不会要求你许愿。
So God does not require you to make a vow.
你没有准备好，你就不要许愿。
If you have not prepared yourself, then do not make the vow.
你可以祷告。
You can pray.
你可以祈求。
You can make a request.
求神的怜悯，求神的帮助。
Ask for God's mercy and His help.
你不许愿，他一样会听见。
If you do not make a vow, He will still listen to you.
啊，但是当你愿意，你自己愿意在神面前许愿啊。
But when you're willing to make a vow before God,
许愿一定要还愿。
You must pay what you said in the vow.
他说不要让神因为你的声音来生气啊。
You do not want God to be angry, because of your vow.
然后不要找很多的借口说啊，我搞错了，我许错了。
And you cannot make a lot of excuses of what you have vowed.
他说你不要跑到祭司前面讲你许错了。
And do not go before the messenger of God to say that you have made an error.
因为这个跟祭司一点关系都没有啊。
Because this has nothing to do with the messenger of God.
就算祭司非常体谅。
Even if the messenger of God is very understanding,
但是祭司没有办法帮你改变什么。
But they cannot change the situation.
你只有得到一点点良心上的安慰。
You only have a little bit of comfort for your conscience.
但是神要因你的话而发怒。
But God will be angry because of your words.
所以我们看到米迦的母亲哦。
So when we see Micah's mother,
明明说好了，哎呀，这一笔钱全部要来奉献啊。
She said that she would wholly offer all the silver.
啊，真正要拿出来的时候舍不得啊，拿200出来而已啊。
At the time when she was about to offer, she only took out 200.
我们再重复一次哦。
If we review this,
没有人强迫你要许愿。
No one has forced you to make a vow.
你真的不需要，不需要。
You don't need to.
神没有一定要你许愿才会帮助你，没有这样子的。神从来没有这样要求哦。
God did not say that He will only help you if you make a vow.
神帮助那些心灵谦卑来到他面前的人，神就会听见，神就会帮助啊。
God will help those and listen to those who come before Him with a heart of humility.
哦，所以记住，神没有要求你要许愿。
So remember that God does not require you to make a vow.
许愿是你自己主动。
This is what you do willingly.
啊，但是既然是你主动。
And because you do it yourself,
你既然已经许了愿，你在神面前你就要做到。
Because you have made a vow before God, then you need to fulfill that vow.
神从来没有强迫你。
God has not forced you.
但是既然你自己决定的，
but because you made this decision,
你就要按照你所许的心愿去把它完成。
Then you must do according to the vow that you have made.
免得让神因为你的声音来发怒啊。
Or God will be angry at your excuses.
哦，所以这是我们看到米迦母亲的问题。
So we see this is the problem of Micah's mom.
我们看回来士师记的17章啊。
If you turn back to Judges 17.
17章的第四节。
Verse 4.
第四节，米迦将银子还他母亲，他母亲将200舍客勒银子交给银匠，雕刻一个像，储成一个像，安置在米迦的屋内。第五节
，Verse five，
这米迦有了神像，又制造以弗德和家中的神像，分派他一个儿子做祭司。第六节
，Six，
那时以色列中没有王。个人任意而行。我们今天都谈到米迦的母亲。
We talked about Micah's mom.
那我们现在啊，就来看看米迦这一个人啦、啊。
But now let us study Micah himself.
那米迦是这个整件事情里面的主角。
Micah is the main character.
哦，在这里我们看到啊，一切事情的起因啊，发生啊，都是因为他偷钱啊。
And we see the beginning of all of this resulted from Micah stealing the money.
他不是只有偷一点点哦。
He did not only steal a small amount.
他偷了一笔非常非常庞大的数目。
But he stole a great sum.
在这里讲说啊，他妈妈让他妈妈都非常非常的紧张，甚至非常的生气啊。
And at the time, the mother was very nervous and very angry.
所以啊，我们在这里看到米迦的第一个问题啊。
So the first problem of Micah,
也是反映出当时候以色列人的一个问题。
And it also reflects the problem of the Israelites at the time.
他们有神。
They had God.
他们是特选的民族。
They were the chosen people.
他们有约柜。
They had the ark.
他们有士师。
They had priests.
但是在这一段这么长的漫长的时代里面，
But during this time,
却成为他们的黑暗时期。
It became the dark ages for them.
为什么有神仍然活在黑暗当中呢？
Why is it that they have God but they live in darkness?
这里米迦就告诉我们，因为行为不好啊。
Here it tells us that from Micah that it was because of their actions
was wrong. 你怎么知道米迦行为不好？
How do you know that his actions was wrong?
他会偷东西耶，他会偷东西，你要他行为有多好？
Because he stole, how great would his actions be if he stole?
你或许会说，可是他是偷他妈妈啊。
You might say he stole from his own mother.
偷他妈妈难道不是偷吗？我们的观念有时候很奇怪啊。
Stealing from your own mother, is this not stealing?
哇，好像说啊，这是我的孩子啊，哎呀，反正以后通通是他的，所以偷家里就是没有偷啊。反正以后就是你的嘛。
You might say that this will be your possession and inheritance in the future, so even if you steal it from me, it's not called stealing.
就是因为有这么多不明事理的父母，才会养出一堆乱七八糟的孩子啊。
Because of this wrong understanding from parents, you will have children.
偷东西本身是行为上的偏差。
You will have children with the wrong concept. If you steal, this is the right action.
他偷谁的跟这件事情没有关系啊。
It doesn't matter who you steal from.
只有一个他可以偷啊，可以偷自己的、啊。
You can only steal from yourself.
早上自己藏起来，晚上自己把它偷出来，那没关系，都是你的嘛。
You steal from yourself in the morning, you hide it in the afternoon, you find it again.
这个叫有病啊。
Then you will have a problem.
但是如果你是偷别人的哦。
But if you steal from others.
不管你偷的是谁的。
No matter who you steal from.
不管你偷的数目是多少。
No matter how great or small the sum is.
今天这是一种行为道德品性上的偏差。
This is deviating from what is right.
前几天啊，那个杨志豪，那个加拿大的杨传道来啊。
A few days ago, Preacher Young from Canada was here.
来帮忙那个 Cerritos 的灵恩会。
And he was here helping out with the spiritual convocation at Cerritos Church.
聚会的时候他就讲了一个故事，我觉得非常非常有趣啊。
And during service, he told us a story that I think is very interesting.
他说啊，有一天啊，有一个爸爸收到一通电话哦。
He said one day there was a father who received a call.
结果啊，他跟他的就是一通电话说啊，这个某某家长吗？你的孩子现在在办公室哦，请你赶快来学校。
And so, the parents recently recall saying that their children was in the office at school and for them to come immediately.
爸爸很忙啊，爸爸跟学校讲说，我现在在上班呢，我可以晚一点再去吗？
So the dad said, I'm very busy at work right now, can I go later?
学校说不可以，非常严重，你一定要马上来。
The school said, no, this is very serious, you need to come immediately.
结果啊，爸爸就赶快啊，工作先放着，赶快跑到学校去，很严重啊。
So the dad left his work behind, went to school because it was very serious.
结果啊，到了学校以后啊，他就赶快问老师啊，发生什么事情啊？
And so when he got to school, he asked the teacher what happened.
结果老师就跟他说，
The teacher said,
他说你的儿子偷东西。
Your son has stolen.
你的儿子偷了隔壁的笔啊，他的同学的笔啊。
Your son has stolen the pens and pencils from his neighbor.
这个行啊，这个不可以啊，我们老师问啊，就是偷东西也不承认啊。
And he has denied stealing this.
但是啊，后来找出来啊，你儿子偷东西啊。
In the end, we found it, and we now know that your son stole.
爸爸非常生气啊。
The father was angry.
对着他的儿子大骂。
And said to his son,
谁叫你偷东西的？
And rebuked him, said, Who told you to steal?
你怎么可以偷东西呢？
How can you steal?
爸爸不是一直教你不可以偷东西吗？
Did I not teach you not to steal?
你如果要笔啊，爸爸从公司里面拿回来就好了嘛。
If you want pens and pencils, I'll just take it from work.
所以有时候这就是我们今天家庭里信仰上的问题啊。
So this is the problem of faith in our family life.
所以啊，当我们啊在 当我们在经营我们的家庭啊
，So when we are establishing our families，
很多时候啊，在我们爱孩子的事上，都缺乏了正确的教导。
We lack correct teachings in our love for our children。
就像我刚说，米迦的母亲一定非常爱他。
Just like I said, Micah's mother must love him deeply.
爱到他什么都敢做。
That she would be willing to do anything.
爱到他敢偷家里的钱。
That he was not afraid to steal from his.
你就可以看到说他的行为品性是一个怎么样的人呐、啊、
？So we can see what kind of character he had.
哦，所以今天不是偷多少或是偷谁的问题。
So today is not a matter of the amount that you steal or from who.
而是今天行为上的偏差。
But you have deviated in your actions.
哦，所以啊，为什么以色列人有神仍然非常痛苦？
And so why is it that Israelites, they had God, but they lived very hard lives?
因为他们的行为不好。
Because their actions were not good.
哦，他们又拜偶像。
They worship idols.
哦，他们与外邦人一样。
They were just like the Gentiles.
哦，生活当中没有正确的表现，行为当中常常效法外邦。
They did not have the correct way of living. They were just like the Gentiles.
哦，所以从米迦偷东西啊。
From Micah stealing,
你就知道说以色列人的教导出了问题啦。
You know that there is something wrong in the teaching of the Israelites.
所以我们今天要教导儿女。
Today when we teach our children,
使他能够明白正道。
For them to know the right way.
因为好的品性远比好的成绩来得重要的太多了。
Because good character is more important than good grades.
好的成绩可能能够帮助他走上人生的下一个阶段。
Good grades might carry them through to the next stage in life.
但是好的品性却能够帮他铺取出人生光明的结果。
But a good character will lead to a good result in life.
一个只是很短暂的。
One is very short.
一个却能够照管他的一生，看顾他的一生。
But one will look after his whole life.
哦，所以我们希望生命当中有神的同在，有神的恩惠与我们常与我们同在。
We want God's abundance and His grace in our life.
我们要先检讨反省自己的行为啊。
But we must first reflect on our own actions.
我们是不是像这个米迦一样啊
？Are we just like Micah?
哇，常常拜神有神像。
That we worship God.
啊，但是行为不检，偷东西呀。
But our actions we steal.
我们的行为会直接决定神要不要垂听我们的祷告。
Our actions will determine whether or not God will listen to our prayers.
我们行为会直接决定神要不要与我们同在。
Our actions will determine whether or not God will abide with us.
哦，所以啊，在诗篇里面，当大卫在祷告哦。
So when David prayed in Psalms.
大卫常常祷告说：“神啊，你看看我。”有什么不是？有没有什么不好的
？He would often pray to God to search his heart to see if there's any wrongdoing.
求你让我改变，求你帮助我改变。
Please help me to change.
使我的祷告能够达到你的面前。
So that my prayers can come before you.
哦，所以在这里，米迦的第一个问题就是行为不检，偷东西。
And so the first problem of Micah was his actions that he stole.
不好恶劣的行为决定了神不与他们同在。
And this bad action resulted in God not abiding with them.
米迦的第二个问题啊。
The second problem of Micah.
在这里讲说，我们看看后面的第二节啊。
Verse two.
他对母亲说：“你那1100舍客勒被拿去，你因此咒诅，告诉了我。看哪、啊，银子在我这里呀、啊。”从这一节里面，我们发现一件事情啊。
From this verse, we realize something.
米迦原本有没有要把钱还给他妈妈
？Did Micah want to return the money back?
没有。
No.
我拿到了，我摸到的就是我的。
I took it. What I touched, this is mine.
啊，非常土匪哦。
It's very barbaric.
啊，这个其实啊。这个如果发生在小孩子身上，这是很正常的啦。
It's very normal for children to act this way.
我们家小孩也是这样啊，他看到的就是他的。
My own children, whatever they see, it is theirs.
哇，所以土匪啊，我每次只要我有什么新玩具，我儿子抢了就跑啊。
And so, whatever new toys I have, my son would take it and run.
他都跟我讲说，卖卖，我的我的啊，抢了就跑啊，们怎么办？对。
He would take it and say, it's mine, and just run.
他六岁。
He's six.
啊，所以啊，有时候啊，小孩子不懂事。
Sometimes children don't know any better.
所以他拿了就觉得说、啊、他拿的就是他的、
so、
他摸到的就是他的。
They think that whatever they touch is theirs.
啊，这个都要慢慢的教导，慢慢他就会长大，就会明白哦。
But you must teach them, and as they grow, they will understand.
米迦是小朋友吗
？But is Micah a child?
我们有时候觉得啊，从你如果只有从这一段来看哦，你从这一段来看哦。
If you only look at this passage,
你觉得米迦大概几岁
How old do you think Micah is?
啊，这里啊，他跟他妈妈说啊，妈妈妈妈，你说啊，有人偷钱啊，啊，不好意思啊，是我偷的啦。你觉得米迦几岁？
Here he said, Mom, Mom, you said someone stole your money. Here it is. How old do you think he is?
其实我们有时候感觉啊，米迦很像那个什么 rebellious teenager 哈，就是那个叛逆少年期嘛，对不对？
So sometimes you might think that Mike is like a rebellious teenager.
哇，可能啊，16-20啊，最叛逆的时候，16-18最叛逆的时候哦。
Maybe he is between 16-18 years old when you're the most rebellious.
米迦到底几岁啊？
How old is Micah?
这里讲说米迦立他的一个儿子做祭司哦。我们看一下啊，哦，我们看第五节啊。
Let us look at verse 5.
米迦有了神堂，制造以弗德和家中的神像，分派他一个儿子做祭司啊。
Here it says, the man Micah had a shrine and made an ephod and household idols, and he consecrated one of his sons who became his priest.
米迦是有儿子的。
So he had a son.
好，有儿子，你说有人有儿子很年轻啊。
Maybe he had a son when he was young.
啊，没关系，你尽量讲，19-18，随便你，好。
You might say 19 or 18.
啊，但是米迦的儿子都可以做祭司哦。
But his son was old enough to be a priest.
应该不会两岁吧？
I don't think he would be 2 years old.
你不要说很多，至少15吧。
He might be at least 15 years old.
哦，你说15-16好了，勉强啊，我立我一个儿子做祭司啊。
Maybe you're pushing it by saying that he's 15-16 years old.
那你不会说啊，找个两岁的、三岁还在那里爬啊，不会嘛
？You wouldn't choose your son who's 2 or 3 years old and still crawling on the floor to be a priest.
啊，然后弯腰说，你做我的祭司哦。
And you bend over and tell him, "You be my priest."
所以啊，米迦的儿子一定不小了。
So Micah's son cannot be that young.
如果再反射过来，反映到米迦自己的年纪呢
？So if this reflects back onto Micah's age,
米迦大概30-40是跑不掉的啊。
He must be at least 30-40 years old.
那但是你看，发觉说啊，他虽然年纪不小，但是行为非常幼稚。
And even though he was not young in age, he was very immature in his actions.
很多道理完全都不明白。
He did not understand a lot of teachings.
这可能跟家里非常宠爱、溺爱有直接的关系呀。
Maybe he was spoiled in his family.
哦，所以啊，米迦很多东西都不懂啊。
So Micah did not understand a lot of things.
哦，所以这里说啊，米迦跟妈妈讲，妈妈，你说，有人偷你的钱啊。
So here Micah said, Mother, you said that someone stole your money.
而且你咒诅哦，我听到喽，你跟我讲了哦，你咒诅哦，好可怕。
And you put a curse on it. I've heard it.
啊，这里是。是那些 被拿走的钱啊
Here's the silver with me.
是我拿的
I took it.
你在这里发现一件事情啊
Here you realize one thing.
米迦为什么会把钱拿出来
Why would Micah take out the money?
因为他害怕
Because he was afraid.
他害怕什么
What was he afraid of?
他害怕他母亲的咒诅会实现啊
He was afraid that his mother's curse would come true.
所以我们在这里发现米迦的一个问题哦
So we will realize the problem, Micah.
在他的信仰观念里面没有对错之分哦。
In his concept of faith, there is no concept of right and wrong.
他把钱拿出来还给他妈妈。
When he took out his money to return to his mother,
不是因为他觉得啊良心不平安，他觉得神在责备他，他觉得他的行为没有符合以色列人的表现，不是啊。
Not because his conscience rebuked him, it was not because God rebuked him, or he felt that his actions was not fitting for Israelite.
不是觉得说，哎呀，我做错了，我一个基督徒怎么可以这个样？对不起，我一个以色列人，我怎么可以这个样子呢
？It's not that he felt that he had done something wrong, that he should not act this way as an Israelite.
我对不起神，我对不起我妈，我要悔改，我钱要还了，不是啊。
I have wronged my mother, I've wronged God, that I need to repent and return this money.
他会还钱的唯一的一个原因呢、啊、
？But the reason why he returned the money.
他怕咒诅。
Was because he was afraid of the curse.
这是一个信仰上的悲哀啊。
This is tragedy in his faith.
他说，当我们今天信仰如果走到只剩下恐惧而已啊。
In the end of our faith is comes down to despair.
啊，我为什么要来教会
？Why do I come to church?
啊，我怕我不来哈、啊，神会让我遭灾。
I am afraid if I don't come, then God will allow me to encounter disaster.
我为什么要做圣工
？Why do I need to do holy work?
我怕我不做圣工啊，我生活当中会倒霉。
I fear that my life would be very bad if I don't.
如果今天一个人信仰上最后只剩下恐惧而已啊
，If a person's faith comes down to fear,
这种信仰问题大的，危险大了啊。
Then this is very bad. This is very dangerous in your faith.
我们来看罗马书的第十一章哦。
If you turn to Romans chapter 11,
罗马书的第十一章。
Romans 11.
罗马书十一章的第22节啊
Verse 22.
22节。
Verse 22。
他说：“可见神的恩慈和严厉，向那跌倒的人是严厉的，向你是有恩慈的，只要你长久在他的恩慈里。”在这里啊，保罗告诉我们哦。
Here Paul tells us。
他说啊，神可以用恩慈的一面对你。
That God can show you goodness.
也可以用严厉的一面对你啊。
And also severity.
那但是为什么会用严厉对你呢？
Why would He show you severity?
他说，如果你跌倒的话。
If you fall.
如果你没有长久在神的恩慈里面。
If you do not continue in His goodness.
你到最后所得到的、所收获的，就只有严厉、恐惧、战惊而已啊。
Then in the end, all you have obtained is severity and fear.
哦，所以我们今天信仰不要只剩下严厉，只剩下这种恐惧。
So in the end, let us not let our faith just result in fear.
拜神不能够只剩下因为怕被神处罚。
You cannot worship God because you're afraid of His punishment.
为什么要这么消极？为什么这么 passive？
Why are you so passive?
信仰难道不能够积极比较 active 一点吗？
Can you not be more proactive in your faith?
为什么一直要想说，哎，我做这样会不会被神处罚？我走到这一步会不会被神击打呢？
Why do you think if I do this, will I be punished by God?
一个人为什么会常常这样想？
Why would a person think this way?
很简单，因为常常游走在信仰的灰色地带，不是吗？
Because they often walk in the gray areas in the faith.
保罗会这样想吗？
Paul, will he think this way?
保罗会每天想说，哎呀，我会不会被神击打，我会被神处罚？保罗不会啊。
Will Paul think that he will be punished by God each day?
因为保罗从来不走在信仰的灰色地带。
No, he will not because he never walks in the gray areas in his faith.
什么人整天紧张得不得了，怕被神处罚呢？
Who are those who fear each day that they will be punished by God?
活在恐惧当中，很怕神的咒诅临到。
Who live in fear and are afraid to be cursed by God.
就是那种喜欢啊，在神的，在，就是在那个边缘地带，神的规定的边缘一点点啊，在那里游来游去啊。
Those who like to dwell on the boundaries of where God sets His rules.
哦，所以你看呢，米迦对神有什么认识？只有一个恐惧而已啊。
So what was Micah's understanding of God? It was fear.
啊，为什么会恐惧
？And why does he fear?
又回到原来，因为他行为不好啊。
And it was because his actions were not good.
我们今天不要只剩下一个恐惧的信仰。
Today we cannot have a faith just be result of fear.
要更积极。
We must be more proactive.
像这些使徒。
Just like the apostles.
我每天积极为主耶稣发光。
Every day I'm proactive in being the light for God.
我点燃我的生命来为主耶稣侍奉。
I will light my life so that I can dedicate it to God.
你看这些使徒哪一个是活在恐惧里面的？
These apostles, who of them lived in fear?
保罗说啊，天上那荣耀的冠冕为我存留啊，他有恐惧吗？
Paul says there's a crown of righteousness waiting for me. Does he have fear?
非常有把握，我一定进天国啊。
He assures that he will go to heaven.
这是我们所需要追求的。
This is what we should pursue.
更是我们必须要拥有信仰上的感动。
And this is something that we should experience in our faith.
不要像米迦一样的可怜。
We should not be as Micah.
让我们活在喜悦当中。
That we should live in joy.
让我们享受我们的信仰。
So that we can enjoy our faith.
而让我们常常看见为我们预备的奖赏。
So we can see the reward that is prepared for us.
让我们生命当中充满了神来的荣耀。
So our lives can be filled with the glory of God.
一起同心默祷。
Let's pray in silence.